tell someone about the flat earth, they usually don't get the point. So some of those who know a little bit of math, they start testing things mathematically, and of course, they get the results that are shown in the textbooks or Google or Giggle. And they think that it's correct, but they don't realize that everything is already calculated, and no matter how good you are at math, if you don't understand the game, you will end up doing what they want you to do. You will be trapped inside your own head. You're probably asking yourself why I'm saying this. Well, a few people wanted me to watch a video of some guy who was trying to calculate the distance to the ISS using some good stupid math. And I'm calling it good stupid math because it's a good math, but it's also stupid. Obviously that guy is a troll or something. Anyone who's been long enough in this flat earth community knows who the trolls are. I'm not trying to offend him, but this is the truth. If he thinks we are stupid, then why can't he just leave us alone?
Leave us alone, kid!
And go on with his life. I don't debunk trolls, I just ignore them. But the reason why I'm making this video is because this is going to open other people's brain. So my goal is not to debunk him, but to use his video as an example to those who think that math proves anything. I think this is a good video to help people get the point. So, Mr. Reds or whatever your name is, you can insult me if you want, but this is the first and the last thing you will ever receive from me. To me, you never existed and you will never exist. Now let's watch a little bit of his video.
So the first thing we need to do is find angle A on our diagram. Okay. And since angle A equals angle B, we can knock out two birds with one stone. Oh. Now the angular size of the moon is known. A simple search on Google will show that it's about 0.52 degrees wide as seen from Earth. If we overlay our two tracks together, we can see that our two tracks span a certain amount of the moon. Okay. In counting the pixel diameter of the moon from Astronomy Live's footage, we see the moon is about 962 pixels wide. Wow. The span of our two tracks from center to center is about 224 pixels wide. Okay. If we take 962 and divide it by 224, we get a ratio of 4.29 to 1. Okay. So, if we take the angular size of the moon as 0.52 degrees and divide it by the value we just found, 4.29, that means angle A in our diagram comes out to 0.1212 degrees. Wow. And since angle A equals angle B, that means B is also equal to 0.1212 degrees.
Wow.
Now that we have angle B, we now need to find our baseline. Our baseline is the distance between myself and Astronomy Live during our observation. And according to Google Earth and the fucking ruler tool, we were about 1.11 kilometers apart. Yeah, that was easy. Now we have everything we need to do some basic trigonometry and figure out how far away we were from the International Space Station during the observation. Okay. To do this, let's cut our triangle in half along with its values, making it a right triangle. And what we're looking for is length x. Okay. Because length x is the distance between us and the International Space Station during the observation.
Okay.
So let's go ahead and solve for x. 0.555 kilometers divided by the tangent of 0.0606 degrees gives us a value for x of 524.73 kilometers, or 326.05 miles. This means that during our observation, we were seeing the ISS from 326 miles away. Good
All right, let's analyze it. Here is his math. The pixels of the moon, 962 divided by the pixels between the two tracks, 224, equals 4.29. Now he takes the angular radius of the moon, that is 0.52, and divides it by 4.29, and he gets 0.1212. So that is A and B angle. Now he just needed the distance between him and his troll friend, which is 1.11 kilometers. Now he decided to cut the triangle in half, so 0.1212 becomes 0.0606, and 1.11 kilometers becomes 0.555 kilometers. Now he wants the distance x, which is the distance to the ISS. So he did this.
0.555 divided by tangents of 0.0606, and he got 524 kilometers.
Wow.
Impressive. That is just 116 kilometers more than the average altitude of the ISS. Wow. Very close.
X of 524.73 kilometers, or 326.0.
I looked up the pixels in his links, but I found no description of how he got the pixels of the moon, so I can't judge that. But I wonder if he just made it up to make his math look like that. Kind of accurate. The most important number of everything he has done looks made up, and it has to be made up. But anyway, I'm going to assume that his numbers are fairly accurate. So he googled stuff, and he filmed the ISS, and did some impressive math, and magically, it matched with Google. So therefore, the ISS is real. Wait. Seriously? So I'm gonna give him an example here, and I will pray for him to understand the point. Now imagine I am NASA and Google Mr. Reds, and I'm gonna give you the distances you need. So I will give you the distance to the moon and the distance to the ISS. I will just make up a number, of course. I actually can choose any distance to the moon, and your beautiful math will match my math. Therefore, the ISS is gonna be real again, right? Mr. Reds, please do it. So I'm gonna make up a small number so I can zoom in and out easily in my software. So let's assume that the distance to the moon is 150,000 kilometers. The distance to the ISS is 211 kilometers. So these are my official numbers that you cannot change. Now you are, as an investigator, you have to do your math to see if my ISS is really at that height. So let's continue with the official data that we already know. Moon radius is the same, 1,738 kilometers. Angular radius therefore has to be 0.011 radians, and this is how we get it. We divide the radius of the moon by the distance. I am just doing what Google does, okay? Since one radian is 57.3, as Google says, then here is what we should do. 0.0115866667 times 57.3. equals 0.66. A lot of sixes here. I don't know why. So its diameter is 1.32 degrees. Alright? And this is how we get it. 0.66 times 2 equals 1.32. We just double it, okay? Now, we keep your own pixels because we have no idea if they are correct or not, but we don't care. We're just gonna keep them because maybe they are correct. 962 pixels and 224 pixels. So we divide 962 by 224, so we get 4.29. All right. Now we do what he did. 1.32 divided by 4.29 equals 0.307, which is angle A and B. Now, as we have angle A and B, we should find his baseline. We keep it as it is, 1.11 kilometers as well. We don't even have to change anything. Changing the distance to the moon and the ISS is more than enough. Now we cut the triangle in half like he did, and we get this angle, 0.153. And the distance becomes 0.555 kilometers instead of 1.11 kilometers. Very simple math. So, 0.555 kilometers divided by tangent of 0.153 degrees equals 207 kilometers. Very close, huh? If we use all the decimals, we get exactly 211 kilometers, like the distance I gave you at first. Oh, wow. That is even more accurate than his math. Therefore, the ISS is more than real. And the moon is 150,000 kilometers this time.
I just proved it, you dumb flat hearts.
Please choose a random distance and do the same math, and you will get an altitude of an ISS. put the new distance to the moon and the ISS in Google, and the world is fooled again. See, math can fool people who think they are smart when they are not. Now, just to make him a little bit angry, let's skip to 44 seconds and pause. Now memorize the track. Now skip to 6:20 and pause and memorize the track again. The tracks are not well drawn on the moon in 9:33. They should be pretty much like this picture. Now at least get your tracks right, Mr. Reds. Stop fooling people who think you are good at math. You are not. By the way, Reds, this Earth and moon that you thought they were spherical, they are not. They are flat, as you can see. We will talk about this in the next video with Karen B. We're gonna debunk Neil deGrasse Tyson. Thanks for watching.
We hope you enjoyed this video presentation by Dr. Zack. If you found this video informative, please like and share and subscribe to Dr. Zack. You can email Dr. Zack at zicoworld123@gmail.com. And thank you for watching.